Exercise 15.06. Dismantle, clean, reset, fit and fine-tune carburetor. Students, at the end of this exercise, you shall be able to understand the following tasks. Dismantle a carburetor. Identify the components in the carburetor. Clean the carburetor and its parts. Check the working of float, main and idling jet. Assemble the parts of the carburetor. Adjust the idling screw and air bleeding screw in a carburetor.
Task 1. Locate the carburetor. It will be below the fuel tank. Wipe any dust, oil on the carburetor with a clean cloth. Close the fuel tap to prevent wastage of fuel due to overflow when the fuel filter hose is removed. Use suitable double spanner to loosen the throttle cable connecting the carburetor. Use a suitable screwdriver to loosen the screws connecting the carburetor to the air filter unit. Use a suitable screwdriver to loosen the screws connecting the carburetor to the inlet manifold. Loosen the choke lever using a suitable spanner. Remove the carburetor and place it in a clean container or tray. Loosen the float chamber securing screws. Remove the fuel overflow hose from the bottom. Remove the seal and place it in a secured place. Remove the idling screw or jet and air screw. Remove all the components like primary or main jet, float, pin and lock, etc. and put it in the tray. Task 2. Collect about 50 ml petrol from the tank by opening the fuel tap and clean all the components thoroughly. Kerosene may also be used. Check the main jet for any block. Insert a small wire, clean the gap and blow compressed air to remove any dust. Check the float for any puncture. A punctured float may not function properly and may lead to wastage of fuel by not closing the fuel supply once the sump is full. Replace the float if necessary. Blow compressed air over the carburetor thoroughly to remove any dirt or moisture. Task 3. Assemble the components one by one in the reverse order. The float, main jet, air bleeding screw. Connect overflowing hose. Connect the throttle cable and connect the choke lever. Check whether they are operating normally by pulling them. Connect the air filter unit. Connect the carburetor to intake manifold and tighten the lock nuts using suitable screwdriver. Connect the fuel inlet hose and open the fuel tap, allowing fuel to flow to the carburetor. Wait for 2 minutes and start the engine and allow it to warm up. Adjust the idling screw to make sure that engine rotates crankshaft at 1500 rotations per minute. Under cold conditions, set the idling at 1300 RPM, which will increase when the engine warms up. Also, adjust the air bleeding screw suitably. Take a test drive and do corrective action if necessary. Thank you.
15.07 Dismantle, clean, check, repair and refit clutch and gearbox. Students, at the end of this exercise, you shall be able to understand the following tasks. Identify parts of a clutch. Dismantle multi-plate type clutch. Inspect the part of a clutch. Replace the defective clutch parts. Remove the gearbox. Identify the various parts of gearbox. Check the gearbox part for damage, wear and tear. Replace clutch lining and assemble the clutch.
Dismantling. Dismantle the transmission from the engine using suitable tools. DE spanner, puller and plier, etc. Remove the crankcase cover of the clutch housing. Using a clutch puller, remove the pressure and clutch plates. Place the clutch assembly on the jig aligning slots on the clutch jig with the thrust pad seat on the pressure plate. Loosen the pressure pad mounting screw and then remove the pressure pads. Release the load from the spring cups. Clean or check. Wash the flywheel, ring gear and pressure plate using kerosene. Also, inspect for any cracks and burnt spots. Check the flatness of the friction faces of the pressure plate and flywheel with straight edge. If the flatness is not found within the specified limit, then the pressure plate and flywheel can be ground. Do not grind below the minimum specified thickness. Clean the clutch linkages, eccentric pin and bush, withdrawal plate and clutch finger brackets. Also inspect the withdrawal bearing and thrust pad. Check the free length and tension of the pressure springs. Replace the springs which do not conform with the manufacturer's specification. Measure the thickness of the clutch liner. Replace the clutch lining if the thickness is less than the specified thickness. Refit or assembling. Place the clutch fingers brush in the clutch finger. Fit the clutch finger bracket on the clutch cover and fit the clutch finger with the bracket with the eccentric pin. Align marks of the clutch cover and pressure plate and place the clutch cover on the pressure plate. Compress the springs with a clutch jig. Place the pressure plate on the clutch jig. Place the pressure pad on the pressure plate and tighten the pad's mounting set screws. Release the load from the springs and remove the clutch cover assembly from the clutch jig. Place the withdrawal plate on the clutch finger. Place the withdrawal plate's retaining plate on the clutch and tighten the mounting set screws of the withdrawal plate. Check the clutch, engage and disengage. Inspection or clean. Clean all the components. Visually the following parts for wear or damage and replace defective parts. Main shaft gear and dog teeth. Counter shaft and its gear. Drive shaft gear teeth and pilot bearing seat. Gear casing and bearing seats in the gear case. Main shaft, splines and pilot bearing seat on the main shaft. Bearings of the main shaft, counter shaft and pinion shaft. Assembling. Place the oil seal in the rear end cover. Place the drift on the oil seal. Ensure that the drift sits squarely on the oil seal's face. Press the oil seal in the cover by the drift. Fit the oil seal in the front end cover using the drift. Mount the gearbox casing on the stand. Lower down the countershaft gears in the gear casing and fit the outer races of the countershaft bearings. Clamp the countershaft in its position temporarily by fixing clamps. Fix the reverse idler gear along with its shaft on the stand. Assemble the gears, bushes, fixed dog clutches and the washer on the main shaft. Place the pilot bearing on the main shaft. Put a belt on the main shaft in the front and rear side in such a way that the assembled components do not slide on the rear side of the main shaft. Place the drive shaft in the casing. Lock the main shaft and tighten the front end nut at the specified torque. Tap the drive shaft by a mallet and rotate by hand to ensure that the pilot bearing on the main shaft sits squarely in the drive shaft's bore. Place the selector assembly on the gearbox. Mounting set screws. Fill the recommended gear oil to the given level.
ISO 15.08. Lubricate and grease the vehicle. Students, at the end of this exercise, you shall be able to understand the following tasks. Identify the points where lubrication or grease is to be done. Use grease pump for lubricating vehicle parts. Use oil can for lubricating vehicle parts. List out various lubricants or grease used in a vehicle.
Clean the grease gun with a neat cloth and wipe off any dirt or dust from the grease nipple. Fill the grease gun with recommended grease and pump the grease to various points requiring lubrication. Pump grease on the clutch and front brake inner cables. Also, pump grease on the steering stem. Pump grease on speedometer shaft. Grease the front and rear brake camshafts. Fill an oil can with recommended oil and spray over the different parts of the vehicle. Spray oil on the chain completely. Also, lubricate the gear shift lever with recommended lubricant. Lubricate the brake suitably. Lubricate the wheel, bolt and nut.
Exercise 15.09. Prepare electrolyte and charge the battery. Students, this video programming is a supporting material for your textbook. Before you begin each exercise, please study the related theory given in the textbook. Prepare the electrolyte using hydrometer for checking specific gravity of the battery. Charge the battery under different conditions. Identify the methods of charging.
The amount of current a battery can deliver depends on total area and volume of the active plate material and the strength of the electrolyte. Preparation of electrolyte. Take about 64 ml of distilled water in a beaker. Take about 36 ml of concentrated sulfuric acid in another beaker. Add the sulfuric acid in the beaker to the beaker containing water. Care should be taken not to pour water to sulfuric acid as it may increase the temperature and the mixture may explode due to liberation of large amount of heat. Also, sulfuric acid is very corrosive. Use suitable protective devices like goggles, acid-proof funnel while preparing the electrolyte. Now, the electrolyte is ready and it should be added to an empty battery and be kept under charging condition. Specific gravity of water is 1 and specific gravity of sulfuric acid 36% is 1.835. As such, the specific gravity of final electrolyte should be 1.27, which is to be tested with a hydrometer. Check the electrolyte level of the battery. Charging the battery with low electrolyte level may damage it. Charging the battery with high electrolyte level may cause overflow of electrolyte due to gassing and heat. Battery can be charged quickly or slowly. Connect the positive terminal of the battery to the positive terminal of the charger. Connect the negative terminal of the battery to the negative terminal of the charger. Ensure that the connections are tight to avoid sparking. Switch on the battery charger. The charging condition may be under constant voltage or current condition. Check the temperature and specific gravity of the battery periodically during charging. If the temperature goes beyond 125 degree Fahrenheit, that is 51.7 degrees Celsius, stop the charge. The battery is fully charged when the specific gravity remains constant for 3 hours and also the cells should be gassing freely. A load or resistance of 3 times the battery ampere hour capacity is placed on the battery. If the voltage at the end of 15 seconds read 9.6 volt or higher, then the battery is good. If the voltage at the end of 15 seconds is less than 9.6 volts, then test the specific gravity of each cell. If the difference between 2 cells is more than 50 points, 0.05 volt, then the battery has to be replaced. Battery capacity test. Adjust resistance until ammeter reads 3 times ampere hour rating of battery. Hold for 15 seconds and note voltage. If voltage is over 9.6, check specific gravity. Charge battery is below 1.230. Otherwise, battery is okay. If voltage is less than 9.6, check specific gravity of each cell. If it is less than 50 points between cells, 0.050 volts, add water if necessary and charge battery per charging schedule and repeat capacity test. If total voltage less than 9.6, replace battery. If total voltage is more than 9.6, battery is serviceable.
Students, till now we have seen few exercises from the lesson repair and overhauling of two-wheelers, motorcycle. We will see the remaining exercises in the next program. Thank you.
You have already gained experience in turning a step job, forming squash shoulder, and also the taper piece part. In this program, we shall learn to plane turn the job as per the specification. Take a cylindrical raw material, set the job in a 4-jaw chuck, hold and true the job, keeping about 15 mm to 20 mm outside the chuck. Face one end of the job. Fix drill chuck in the tailstock spindle. Fix the center drill in the drill chuck. Center drill on the face of the job. Remove and mark the length 150 mm on unfinished side. Reverse and reset the job. Face up to the mark. Center drill on the face of the job. Remove the job and check the length. Remove the chuck and mount a dividing plate or a catch plate on the spindle nose. Fix a live center into the headstock spindle. Fix a dead center in the tailstock spindle nose. check the true running of the live center. Attach a lathe carrier, straight or bent, according to the plate fixed in the spindle. Apply grease to the center hole of the work in the tailstock side. Move the tailstock according to the length of job. Set the work between centers. Turn the job to the possible length. Chamfer the 3x45. Remove the job from the lathe. Refix the lathe carrier on the other end of the job. Refix the job between centers. Turn the remaining length. Chamfer the end. Check the size. Till now, you have learned the method to plain turn the job between centers for a given specification. Let us have a quick recap of all that we have learnt in this program. Set the job in a four-jaw chuck and true it. Face one end. Fix the drill chuck. Fix the center drill. Reverse. Reset. And redo. Mount a dividing or catch plate. Attach a lathe carrier. Adjust the tailstock. Turn the job. Set the work between centers. Turn it to the specification. Chamfer and deburr. Precision work always pays. With this note, we come to the end of this program. We are already familiar with the lathe, its different parts and its operations. We have also learned the method for turning a step job as per the given specifications. Similarly, in this program, we shall learn the method to step turn for another specification. The dimensions are shown in the figure. Take a cylindrical raw material as per the dimensions notified. Set the job in a four-jaw chuck. Face and turn. Check dia and length. Turn forming square shoulder and check. shoulder squareness. Reverse and hold die at 20 by 10 in the chuck using aluminium pieces. Mark 20 mm on die at 35. Turn up to the mark. Turn, face and finish. And check dia and shoulder. Deburr all the sharp corners. Till now you have seen how a step turn is done for a given specification forming square shoulder. Let us have a quick recap of what we have understood. Setting the job in a four jaw chuck facing turning. Forming of square shoulder. Reversing. Marking and turning. Checking and deburring. With this, we come to the end of this program. So far, we are familiar with the methods to plane turn and step turn between centers. I hope they were easy to learn and practice. In this program, we shall learn the method to turn and knurl the part shown between centers. Take a cylindrical raw material as per the dimensions specified. Set the job in a four-jaw chuck. Hold and true the job. Face one end and center drill. Face other end and maintain the length center drill. Turn the remaining job to required dimensions. Hold the 90 mm long job between centers. Knurl on diameter 25 to 0.2 mm. Reverse and refix between centers. Turn to the remaining length. Chamfer end to 2 by 45. Deburr and check sizes. Till now, we have learned the step-by-step method to turn and knurl the specified part between centers. Let us have a quick recap of what we have learned. Set the job in a four-jaw chuck. Face and true the job. Turn as per specification. Knurl on dia 25. Reverse and refix between centers. Turn to the remaining length and chamfer. Deburr and check the sizes. Isn't that a wonderful job? By mastering the technique, you too can do it easily. With that note, we come to the end of this program. Knurl on diameter 9 to 0.2 to the required length using knurling tool. Calculate the taper of the front portion of dot punch. Set and turn taper. Reverse and reset to turn the front portion. Set to turn tapers as per the drawing. Check all the dimensions. Till now, we have learned the techniques to turn and prepare a dot punch for the given specification. Set the job in a four-jaw chuck outside the jaw. Face and turn and knurl as per the instructions. Reverse and hold with aluminium pieces, set and turn. Check the dia. Good technicians are not born but are made with sincere practice. You too can achieve perfection. With that note, we come to the end of this program. We are already familiar with operations like turn step, taper, unknurl. Now, in this program, we shall learn how to combine all the three, turn step, taper, and knurl a specified part. Take a cylindrical raw material as per the dimensions specified. Dia 80 by 140. Set the job in a 4-jaw chuck. Face and turn. Reverse and hold the finished end in the chuck. Use aluminium pieces while holding the finished job. Face and finish to size. Set the compound rest to 45 degrees. Turn taper as per drawing and check. Knurl using knurling tool. Till now we have seen the step-by-step method to turn step, taper and knurl a specified part. Let us have a quick recap of what we have learnt. Set the job in a 4-jaw chuck. Face and turn. Reverse and turn to the total length. Face and finish to the size. Knurl on dia 70. Practice makes perfection. Practice the techniques carefully. You too will reach perfection. With that note, we come to the end of this program. You are already familiar with turning a step job and also forming a square shoulder for given specifications. All these works require error-free operation. Hence, you should carefully follow every step of the operation. In this program, we shall learn to turn step and taper piece part as per the given specifications. Take a cylindrical raw material as per the dimensions specified. Set the job in a 4-jaw chuck. Face and turn dia 36 to the possible length. Turn undercut at 30 mm from the free end as per drawing. Check dia 36, dia 30 and length 30 and 10. Reverse and set the job. Use soft jaws, aluminium pieces. Turn dia 36 on the unfinished end. Face and turn. Swivel and set the compound slide to 25 degrees. and check. Turn taper as per drawing. Deburr all the sharp corners. We shall see a fast recap. Set the job in a four-jaw chuck outside the jaw. Face and turn as per the instructions and check the squareness. Reverse and hold with aluminium pieces. Face and turn taper up to the mark. Deburr all the sharp corners. With a little care and attention, you too can do the job easily. With this note, we come to the end of this program. You are familiar with the methods to turn step, taper, knurl, and prepare the dot punch for given specifications. In this program, let us learn to turn the specified piece part with some curve. Take a cylindrical raw material as per the dimensions specified. Set the job in a four-jaw chuck. Face and turn to the possible length. Mark 10 mm parallel portion and R11 curved portion. Turn the curve using carriage and cross slide movement. Hold work for finishing the length and taper. Face to size and turn dia 18 to the remaining length. Set and turn taper. Check all the dimensions. Till now, you have learned the various steps involved to turn the specified piece part. Let us have a quick recap of all that we have learned in this program. Set the job in a four-jaw chuck outside the jaw. Face and turn the curved carriage as per the instruction and mark for the dimensions. Reverse and hold with aluminium pieces. Face and turn up to the mark. Check the dia and shoulder and deburr all the sharp corners. Isn't it amazing to see how learning the basic turning of step jobs to more complex jobs is so easy? Continuous practice will surely make a perfect professional. With that note, we come to the end of this program. Best of luck. So far, we are familiar with plain turning the job between centers for a given specification. I hope it was easy to learn and practice. In this program, we shall turn the stepped part shown between centers for a given specification. Take a cylindrical raw material as per the dimensions specified, namely dia 32 by 155. Turn at tailstock end to a length of 32 mm. Check the diameter and the length. Position the growing tool, leaving 10 mm collar, and reduce the diameter to 24 mm for 20 mm length by giving successive cuts. Turn the remaining material, chamfer 2x45, and check the whole job. Let us have a quick recap. Turn the job to the prescribed length and check the dia. Reduce the diameter, reverse and reset job using soft jaws, chamfer and check the dimensions. Turn the remaining material. With a little effort, you too can do the same job to the given specification. With this, we come to the end of this program. We are already familiar with turning a stepped job forming square shoulder for a given specification. Any such program requires utmost precision. In this program, let's learn to turn the stepped part forming square shoulder for another given specification. Set the job in a four-jaw chuck. Face and turn dia 20 to 15 forming square shoulder. Turn dia 27 by 15 long forming square shoulder and check. Reverse and set the job. Face and turn dia 35 to 15 mm. Check diameter and length. deburr all the sharp corners. We shall see a fast recap of this program. Set the job in a four-jaw chuck outside the jaw. Face and turn as per the instructions. Check the squareness. Reverse and hold with aluminium pieces. Face and turn up to the mark. Check the shoulder and deburr all the sharp corners. Till now, you have seen in detail the various steps involved in turning the stepped part forming square shoulder for a given specification. With this, we come to the end of this program.
नमस्ते रोहन, इन दिनों कहाँ थे तुम?
नमस्ते अंकल, मैं जरा स्कूल के प्रोजेक्ट्स में व्यस्त था, कृपया इसे रख लीजिए।